In the next 15 years, the number of Americans suffering from heart failure is expected to grow by nearly 40%, and the cost of managing it will be more than double. That's why the American Heart Association has launched an awareness initiative called Rise Above Heart Failure. Cardiologist Dr. Clyde Yancy, a past president of the American Heart Association, joins us now with more. First of all, doctor, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. I'm delighted to be with you today.
So, doctor, can you tell us more about heart failure and its impact?
The American Heart Association has launched a campaign known as Rise Above Heart Failure because there's an incredible need and a great opportunity to make a difference here. Heart failure is not a heart attack. It's any condition where the heart is not working properly and it leads to symptoms like shortness of breath and fatigue. Importantly, it's ubiquitous. 1 in 5 Americans will develop this condition before they pass on. So it's not about somebody else, it's about all of us. All of us are at risk. We know that through launching this campaign, if we can raise the awareness, we can drive people to earlier detection, earlier treatment, and we can lower the burden of this condition. So Rise Above Heart Failure is about a very important objective to make a big difference in the lives of people at risk for or those who already have the condition known as heart failure.
So, doctor, what can people do to reduce their risk of heart failure?
One of the important messages that is embedded in Rise Above Heart Failure is the message of prevention. So what people can do to lessen the likelihood of having this condition is to know your blood pressure. If you have high blood pressure, get it treated. Know your blood sugar. If you have diabetes, get that under control. And especially if you're overweight, if you have obesity, then by all means, work hard to get your weight to an appropriate threshold. High blood pressure, obesity, diabetes, those are the risk factors that are most important in developing this condition. The same can be said, by the way, for atherosclerosis, a hardening of the arteries. So having these heart healthy lifestyle issues and opportunities really matter. It can make a big difference.
So doctor, what are some of the signs and symptoms of heart failure and what should we do if we notice them?
What's so important and what's so well laid out in Rise Above Heart Failure is these early warning signs, the symptoms, the first onset of something that should raise someone's attention. So things like shortness of breath, something as subtle as I just feel tired or I feel tired all the time, listlessness, not being very energetic, they all sound very vague. But once you put them in the context of somebody that has high blood pressure or a previous heart attack, you begin to appreciate that perhaps this is heart failure. So never dismiss those vague symptoms. Always be willing to bring them to the attention of a healthcare provider. If it's heart failure, we can do something positive about that.
Doctor, talk a little bit about the initiative and tell us more where our viewers can get more information.
So Rise Above Heart Failure is an important campaign. The goals are simple: to raise awareness by at least 10%, hopefully a lot more, and to reduce the burden of disease, particularly hospitalizations, by at least 10%, if not a lot more. We have all of this well depicted at the website riseabovehf.org. For general information about heart disease and heart disease prevention, stroke prevention as well, heart.org is a great resource. And then especially between February 14th and February 20th, Heart Failure Awareness Week. Lots of messaging in social media, lay press, medical press, to really help us all understand that we can take failure out of this equation and we can convert heart failure into success by raising the awareness, getting people on therapies, the right therapies at the right time for the right person. We do that, do it well, we can make a big difference.
Doctor, can you tell us more about heart failure and its impact, particularly among African Americans?
So while all of the messaging that's embedded in Rise Above Heart Failure becomes uniquely and acutely important is when we're talking about special populations, especially African Americans. I've studied this population for over 25 years and have recognized the burden of this condition that's embedded within the African American community. The disease happens at least 20 years earlier, meaning that it strikes at peak years of earning and quality of life, family time. This is an unacceptable burden. By raising the awareness of the condition heart failure in the African American community, we can fundamentally change life and living for a very important segment of the population. Again, it's about high blood pressure, it's about obesity, it's about atherosclerosis, it's about diabetes. we can get these messages embedded in the African-American community, we can make a really big difference.
Great information, Doctor. One more time, where can we send our viewers for more information?
So for more information, please go to riseabovehf.org. Please go to heart.org. And pay attention during Heart Failure Awareness Week. Lots of messaging that will be very beneficial.
Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you very much.